Did you just say, who this? And then look in the mirror?
Why is the mirror there in the first place? Like, you know what I mean? Welcome back to part two of my series on animal cognition and communication. If you missed part one, you can find that link down in the descriptions below, or possibly right up here. Can we put it up here?
We'll put it here. It's
right here. This series is in response to a video I published 2 years ago on What About Bunny? The talking dog who had an existential crisis after looking in a mirror. If you don't know who Bunny is, she's a dog who many believe can speak English by pressing buttons. Bunny's existential crisis is one of the videos that many people claim is the best evidence that she is legit.
Did you just say, who this? And then look in the mirror?
I'm KP, I'm a marine biologist who specializes in animal training and behavior. Just like with part one, I'm going to start by addressing some of the criticism of my original video. Specifically, that I should stick to fish, or that I've never owned a dog. Now, these are obviously attempts to dismiss my credibility, which I don't actually mind, because I do think that we all need to be critical on the sources that we take our information from, especially when it comes from social media. Whenever we consume content, we need to ask ourselves, is this source trustworthy? Which is why I like to let people know about my qualifications. For example, I know very little about fish. A more accurate term for my profession would be marine mammalogist, because I work with marine mammals like walruses and sea otters. I also recently started working with small canines like Arctic foxes. And my specialty is in training behaviors, including ones that have been used in peer-reviewed research papers. Second, I grew up with dogs. However, owning a dog doesn't make someone an expert in canine behavior any more than owning a car makes someone a safe driver. Quick disclaimer, this is my personal and professional opinion. We are not going to go harass other content creators for any reason in any way, shape, or form.
Did you just say, who this?
And then look in the mirror?
Who this? That's Bunny.
Why is the mirror there in the first place? Like, you know what I mean? That certainly feels like... We fast forward again, dog kind of wants to go outside. Yeah, that feels very much like she set that up to tell this story, to make this happen. So my goal was actually to look at this video and talk about some of the really cool studies that have been done regarding canine cognition and self-awareness. But this video gave me a really weird vibe, so I decided to take a closer look. From a scientific evidentiary aspect, this video is gold because it isn't edited. There are no cuts, and we can clearly see Bunny's mom press two individual buttons. Who? And this. If we rewind and zoom in, Bunny only presses one button, the button for this. Bunny never pressed the who button, yet we still hear the who. And are told that she said, who this?
Did you just say, who this?
And then look in the mirror?
I've now looked at three videos that were suggested by people who strongly disagree with my original take on What About Bunny. Two of the videos were heavily edited. Fast forwarded, so how long? And the third appears to be staged or outright faked. These videos quite simply would not hold up to a rigorous peer review if they were part of an academic study. But wait, isn't Bunny part of an academic study? Yes! Or maybe. There are some things we need to consider. For starters, the study is funded by the button company itself, and one of the lead researchers is the company's founder and CEO. This is a pretty clear red flag for obvious reasons. Citing Neuroscience News, the company's involvement could be seen as a potential conflict of interest. The company could choose to retain only positive data to better market their boards. Bunny herself is the spokesperson for the company, and most of her videos end with affiliate links to buy the buttons. The study even promotes Bunny's social media as a success story. This ongoing study is often seen as proof that the buttons work and Bunny's conversations are real. Even though this study has been going on for over 3 years and we haven't seen any published results, normally we don't even learn about a study until the results are published and the data is peer-reviewed. I've certainly never seen an ongoing study with this high of a profile on social media. And for good reason. It's the nature of social media to reward success through likes, shares, subscribers. You should click the subscriber button. These rewards create tempting and hard to resist incentives that can damage a study's credibility and reliability, which is why these incentives and conflicts of interest are carefully avoided in most academic research, including research on canine self-awareness and how dogs interact with mirrors, which I think it's time we talk about since it pertains to what about Bunny and her existential crisis. Because the science is clear on this. Only a few animal species have passed the mirror self-recognition test, including great apes, dolphins, elephants, and even some birds like magpies. But no dog has ever passed the mirror self-recognition test. At first, dogs react to mirrors the same way that most animals do, as if it is another member of their species, but they quickly learn to ignore mirrors. While that might seem like I'm saying dogs are dumb, it's actually evidence of the most critical types of learning. Habituation. To respond to every novel or alarming stimulus, regardless of its significance, may waste energy and thus be maladaptive. But there's more. A few years ago, the anthropology research group conducted a really cool study examining how dogs interact with mirrors. Here's what they did. One owner would direct the dog's attention to a mirror, while the second owner stood in a nearby room holding the dog's favorite toy. But the second owner was visible only if the dog looked in the mirror. The results suggest that some dogs understand the nature of reflection, which fits with the claims of some dog owners that they play mirror games at home with their dogs. That's what I think is going on with Bunny. Because if you paused and zoomed in, it's pretty clear that Bunny isn't looking at herself in the mirror. She's looking at her owner. Even in this photo from American Kennel Club, he's targeting the mirror while looking at the person taking the picture. He's probably waiting for a cue that he's a good boy or he did a good job. I think Bunny has been trained to press the buttons and then target the mirror. When she does, she is given a reward, like attention or going outside.
We fast forward again, dog kind of wants to go outside.
Okay.
This is what I find so frustrating about these pet button videos. What is happening in these videos is often misinterpreted intentionally or unintentionally in order to sell a story on social media. Which brings me back to what I touched on in the beginning. Whenever we consume content on social media, we need to think critically and take what we see with a healthy dose of skepticism, especially when it's trying to sell us something. Because I only needed to see the mirror video twice in order to spot the obvious inconsistencies.